Let's get back to the politics of the day. Joining me now, as they do every week, Parnell, Palme, McGuiness and Simon Banks. Parnell, that was one out of left field, wasn't it? Matt Kean arriving at a news conference with the Prime Minister and Energy Minister and now the Chair of the Climate Change Authority.
It certainly was, and yet there were very short odds when Matt Kean announced that he was stepping back from Parliament on him getting a job in the renewable space. So it was out of left field, but then it wasn't actually really. Look, I mean, I think that this is a very clever manoeuvre by the government, because obviously what they're trying to do is put the spotlight on the divisions around energy politics that have been in the coalition over the last couple of decades or decade. And they will want Matt Kean to sort of stand in for that debate during the time. But of course, at the same time, like, Matt Kean has always emphasised his position as an economic rationalist, he always says. So let's see if he is able to keep this position as energy agnostic, or whether he is going to sort of move into being a campaigner on renewables in this area.
Simon Banks, the PM and Energy Minister, say that Mr. Kean is the best man for the job. Looks like a political wedge, though, doesn't it?
Well, maybe, but let's remember, in New South Wales, Matt Kean was able to forge a bipartisan, like, in fact, almost right across the Parliament position in relation to energy policy in New South Wales. It had the support of the Labor Party, obviously had the support of both Liberals and Nationals. It was a policy that had strong support both in Sydney Metro, but also out in the regions. So he's actually a proven record of actually bringing people together, finding pragmatic solutions to deal with this. And one of the interesting things, for example, in New South Wales is that there's significant opposition, for example, with inside the New South Wales Nationals to Peter Dutton's nuclear policy. They don't want it in their backyard. Former Deputy Premier and former leader of the Nationals, Paul O'Toole, for example, opposes the plant that would be going into his electorate. So, look, I think there are very pragmatic reasons, and that's the ultimate reason why nuclear isn't the answer, is it turns up too late and it costs too much.
Yeah, well, that's on the nuclear thing. He was asked about that on the nuclear proposal and went back to his own experience, which is extensive in this space, Parnell, and I know there'll be many Liberals who will be fuming at this move by Matt Kean, but chairing the Climate Change Authority, being involved in this response, is consistent with his political career to this point.
Absolutely. This has always been what he's talked about. And that's what I mean, that, you know, there were short odds on him taking a job in the space. So he's very passionate about renewables. He believes that they are the right way to transition, and he'll talk about the advice that he's taken on that front. So, I mean, you know, there are only two ways that the Liberals can go on this. They either decide to make him an issue by treating him as a pariah and as somebody who's going against them, or they make the point that renewables have to be part of the energy mix, and that we need to be technology agnostic going forward. So absolutely not a surprise from Matt Kean, but it will be interesting to see how the Libs deal with this from a strategic perspective.
It will be because, and I had Anne Rustin on a few minutes ago, and understandably she was immediately after the announcement, so probably not a chance for her to recalibrate with the leadership and others in the Liberal Party. But Parnell, where do you think they'll go with this? Will they seek to play the straight bat and say, well, we'll judge him on his merits and move on? Because there would be many in the party room, maybe not many, but there are some who have a similar worldview to Matt Kean.
A straight bat would be the wisest way to go about it, I would say. But, of course, there will be a lot of fury on the among the Conservatives who don't like Matt Kean, who don't like his push towards renewables and his renewable-only sort of approach. And there will be a lot on the other side, on the moderate side, who are a bit angry about this nuclear policy and feel a bit steamrolled by that, who will be keen to use him as vindication and as their sort of proxy and spokesperson in this space. So, you know, it's always easy to advise the party room from outside it, not so easy to keep it in line when you're in charge. So that will, Dutton will really have his work cut out for him on that.
And it's hard to say it's just a a political stunt, Simon. I know that Anne Rustin was saying it's a distraction, and you can sort of get away with that, but saying it's just a stunt would undermine the record or the experience Kean has as a former Treasurer and Energy Minister who established the renewable energy zones in New South Wales. The guy knows this area pretty well, better than most.
Yeah, and as I said, he actually worked very hard in New South Wales to get as broad a possible support across the New South Wales Parliament for the reforms that he brought in as well. So this is... I know he's a very divisive figure within some aspects of the Liberal Party. I reckon if you had Matt Canavan on, he might have a few choice words about him. But the truth is that in his record in New South Wales is really to try and actually build broad consensus and support for New South Wales's energy policy. And that doesn't have nuclear as part of the mix. He's made his views very publicly over the last few weeks that he doesn't think that nuclear, not for ideological reasons, but for those very pragmatic, traditional Liberal reasons, that basically it comes too late and it costs too much. Yeah. They're the very pragmatic reasons that, you know, he's expressed before. And I don't think anyone expects him to change his mind. Why? Because that's actually what the evidence shows.
Simon and Parnell, great to see you both. Appreciate it as always.